Hello, this is Cristi. In today's Camtasia video, I'm not going to keep you long. I just want to share with you three great keyboard shortcuts that I use in Camtasia every day. And two of them are actually not documented anywhere. You can't find them in the settings screen where you see the shortcut keys. And I haven't found them in any menus or anywhere. I just found them by mistake. So I just want to share with you, and you can save a lot of time with these. So let's just go. The first one is the keyboard shortcut to deselect a selection on your timeline. And that is, if you go to the timeline and maybe you place a clip down here and you zoom in and you make some edits, and at some point you decide you want to make a selection and delete maybe, or do something with a selection like silence, for example, you can use these two little things beside the playhead to change your selection like this. Actually, there was no deselection shortcut key documented. If you right click on this, and you can see in the menu here, it says deselect, but there is no shortcut key for this. Well, the shortcut key, let me tell you, it's Control D. I think on the Mac it's Command D, although I cannot check right now. So Control D, boom, the selection is gone. So I use this all the time. So if you make a selection, boom, boom, you can do whatever, silence it using Shift and S or whatever you want to do. Maybe change the volume. And then when you're done, Control D, the selection is gone. Massive time saver for me, because I was always having to double click on the timeline. That is actually one way that you can remove that selection. So if you have a selection, double click here on the timeline, and the selection is gone. But I think using the shortcut on the keyboard much faster, Control D, boom, it is gone. So then the playhead is placed at the beginning of the former selection. So that was the shortcut number one. Let's go look at the second one. So the second shortcut, and this is great because it gives you so much more accuracy, is when you have a clip on your canvas, or maybe a video clip or an image, or maybe you have an annotation. Let me just drag it here so you can see the effect. And I have some text in here. I'm going to make it really large. So this is your object, right? So now there are some rotation handles on the far side where you have the properties panel, and you can obviously rotate this object using these little knobs right there, but they don't give you a lot of precision. Also, you can rotate this object in 3D, sort of 3D or perspective space, and then you can use the X axis to also turn it all around like this. But for me, because I like a lot of 3D stuff, I like to use my objects and kind of turn them into a bit of a 3D or perspective or something like that. I do not like the way these controls work. The first thing is they are not accurate. So if I want to make a very precise rotation, I have to actually type the value in. Plus, this is the downside also, you cannot move all three at the same time. And that's the thing, because when you move an object in 3D space, you want to see how it looks when you move it around. And I didn't know about the shortcut. So there you go. The shortcut I'm talking about is Control Shift. If you select your object and hold down Control and Shift, now you can use your mouse to drag over the object. And look at this. The object is moving in 3D space on all the axes as you move your mouse. Isn't that cool? So then you can do things like, you can move it all the way to the left. You can add maybe an animation down here, and again, hold the Control and Shift keys and move it to the other side. You can move your mouse to the side to adjust it like this. So there you go. You've created a 3D animation like on the news or something like this. And all you have to do is just go back to the first one if you're not happy with it, and change it. And there you go. 3D space movement with just one shortcut key, Control Shift, hold them down, and you can freehand move your object in 3D space. That is fantastic. I love this, and I use this all the time, and I'm surprised it's not documented anywhere. Maybe it's not something that a lot of people are using, but I like to do a little bit of a 3D in my project. So this is really great. So then the third shortcut key. This is documented and I use it a lot every day. This is like my go-to shortcut key for everything in Camtasia when I want to create an animation. And by that, I mean a custom animation. So you've seen me just now adding an animation here, but I actually did not click anywhere. Normally, when you have an animation to add, you go to the animations and then you go to animations. You choose one of these pre-built animations, or I can just use the custom animation to do everything I need. So I just drag this to my clip right there so I can, you know, adjust it and so on. Well, that is actually much faster to just use the shortcut key. So what you need to do is where you want your animation to stop on the clip. So let's suppose that maybe here, halfway through the clip, I want to have it turn or do something. Place your playhead where you want your animation to stop and then press Shift and A. There you go. So it is adding an animation to that clip. So then, because you have just added it, the playhead is right there at the end. So that's without moving your playhead, move the object to where you want it to go. Maybe I'll put it in the corner down there. Notice because I moved it in 3D space, it keeps its perspective. So now look, my animation is working from the starting point to the end point where I just added it. If you want to change the final position, put the playhead in the final point there or after it, really, and then move it somewhere else, and the animation will instead do that movement, right? So that's it. You know, if you want to make another animation, go to the point where you want it to stop, Shift and A again, and move it to that corner, and there you go. You've added another animation. Very simple, very quick shortcut to add a custom animation. And I say this to everyone, if you learn how to use the custom animation, you don't really need another animation from these pre-made ones, because these pre-made ones are actually just a custom animation with a pre-built sort of path, animation path from A to B, maybe scaling as well, all those things. They are all actually just custom animations pre-built. So I use this all the time, almost exclusively. Sometimes I may use the full opacity, no opacity, because they're a quick way to make something disappear or reappear. But Shift and A will add a custom animation to the current selected clip at the playhead, ending at the playhead. That's all you need to know. So these are very handy shortcut keys. And here's a bonus one. Another shortcut key that I use is just the Shift key. The Shift key pretty much unlocks in Camtasia all of the ripple commands. So ripple move, you go here, you shift and drag the playhead, you've made a cut and you are moving everything forward. The shift and drag, so if I make another cut here, let me just show you. If I make another cut and you click on a clip, shift and move will move everything after that clip as well, all the way up to the end of the timeline. So you can see this is a ripple move. But I have another video where I show you all of these tricks involving the Shift key, and you can watch this on the screen right now. It's recommended here, so you can click to go to watch it. Thank you for watching. Thank you for joining me and for following my channel. And I love to make these tutorials. So if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments, and I will try and make a video for it if I haven't made one already. So thanks again, and I will see you on the next one.